Hi everyone, I'm Mary with Mary Greeley News. Thank you for joining me. Here's an image of Old Faithful taken from multiple pictures of the static cam from yesterday. That whole geyser basin is heating up. Look at all the steam and how dark it is. Back over here, and it looks a little dirty there. Another thing I noticed is how much the ground has heated up. And you can tell that by the snow melt. Yeah, isn't that amazing? So what else is going on? Well, today there was a magnitude 3.6 earthquake there along the sawtooth fault zone. It was also along the trans-Challis fault system. That's that green line I got drawn out. Here's the location of today's 3.6 earthquake using Google Earth. What we have here is an extensional basin that is all the way from the Snake River Plateau and extends all the way up to British Columbia. With all these recent earthquakes that are along the Sawtooth Fault Zone, it sure looks like it's becoming more and more active. Up until about just 10 years ago, they didn't even know about the Sawtooth Fault Zone. And then they thought it was an inactive fault. You can kind of consider it like a rift system where we had spreading here. And millions of years ago, when the Pacific Plate was subducting very rapidly back then under the North American Plate, this is when that was occurring. It created what is called the Challis Volcanic Group. Volcanoes, active volcanoes. Yeah, when you have spreading, much like what's going on with the Ring of Fire, you have volcanic eruptions. The Challis Volcanic Group covers roughly about 25,000 square miles. Using Google Earth, even looking at the geology, yeah, you can see there's a volcano there. You can see the uplift, lava flows, etc. The subduction of the Farallon Plate was evidently very shallow, and it extended all the way to Wyoming. And the movement of the continent during that time was evidently very fast. Well, in geological time, I'm not quite sure how fast that was, but they said it was very fast. And this extension, like I said, comes all the way from the Snake River Plateau, which is the hot spot for Yellowstone, and goes all the way up to British Columbia. Around 56 million years ago, the subduction rate slowed down, and the angle rate of subduction became much deeper. And then that formed many of the rift gabions that are there in Idaho. There is a paper by geology there in Idaho showing how it was shallow at first and then how it went steep and how this created the volcanic field. Scientists believe part of that Farallon Plate is actually underneath Yellowstone. There is a lot of rhyolite flows in this area. There is also a lot of rhyolite plugs showing where the rhyolite explosions occurred. And they didn't even know about this trans-Challis fault zone, rifting system, whatever you want to call it, until the late 1980s. Many of these ancient rift systems, in my opinion, look like they're becoming more active in the last couple of years, specifically probably within the last year to 2 years. I've talked about that. The New Madrid Fault Zone, that is another one of those failed rift systems, meaning the continent of the United States, failed to separate into two different continents. And this is another one here. So here is a spectrogram of that 3.6 earthquake as it came in on the left here at Yellowstone Lake. This is Moose Creek, Idaho. And on the right is Little West Thumb. I haven't done a report about the earthquake activity lately because it's been difficult to pull the data for some reason. It's been blocked or the equipment there hasn't been working or something. So this 3.6 earthquake was about 12 miles below sea level. They supposedly measure all earthquakes from sea level, or 20.4 kilometers in depth. No one supposedly reported feeling this earthquake. So here on USGS, there's the location of the 3.6. Afterwards, there was a magnitude 2.5, about the same depth. And then over by the Sawtooth Fault Zone, a magnitude 2.3. Those are all today. There was also before, in another location, but close to Stanley, Idaho, a magnitude 1.8, a 1.7. Now that would actually be the Sawtooth. A 2.0, again, Sawtooth. A 2.4 Sawtooth. See how they're popping up and down along that entire line? And that's it for today. I really believe that many of these scientists know what's coming. They have recognized these increase in earthquakes. The Earth core is heating up, creating earthquakes and volcanic eruptions around the world. Again, here's that 3.6. This is all the recent earthquakes that I have marked out. But I also noticed as these continents seemed to be moving, there was earthquakes too, over here by the Cascade Reservoir. Yeah, this has got some geothermal possibilities. Yeah, my cats are fighting for some reason. They've done so little study and research. Like I said, the Sawtooth Fault Zone, they didn't even know existed until about 10 years ago. And so only recently have they been studying this fault zone here by the Cascade Reservoir and the heated water that is coming up in this area. They don't know if the heated water is coming up because of faults or could it be something else. They just don't know. Somewhere down there, they have a reserve of magma. So we'll come back over here. And I keep telling you guys, this is all connected to the Yellowstone caldera. And they keep wanting to say, oh, no, it's not. Well, I'm sorry, but it is. I've talked about the crack down there, the dike intrusion of rhyolite that's trying to come up at the bottom of Yellowstone Lake. Can you see all the earthquakes here that have been occurring there at Yellowstone Lake? They had one earthquake late yesterday, Universal Time, 21:41. Here it is at Yellowstone Lake. This is Maple Creek, and then on the right would be Little West Thumb. That earthquake, of course, they're not reporting. They are reporting yesterday a 2.4 by Hedgen Lake, 12.9 kilometers in depth. So that would be about 8.2 miles in depth. The day before that, same location, a 1.2. Also on the 14th, a 1.6, same location. You can see there's nothing really for the Yellowstone area that they are reporting. The 14th, a 0.1. And we know they downgrade these. This here is from the 14th, a 0.4. That would be the Madison River area, and I've talked about that a lot. The Madison River actually reversed its course because of uplift from the Yellowstone caldera. It actually started flowing the opposite direction because of the uplift that's going on there. So, okay, that's a 0.4 Madison River. 2.1. Where is that? Oh, okay, 2.1 up there. A 0.3, again, the Madison River area. How can they do this? A minus 1.0. See, there's Madison River. Let me zoom in a little bit. There we go. Those are all the earthquakes within the last week. So that one, they're not reporting. This one here earlier at 1958, that probably was Challis, Idaho. Close to that direction. There is one in red down here. Let's see. Right there. Oh, that's the one I think I just got done showing you. Yeah. Another very small microquake at 2231 This is westbound, Challis, Idaho. Yeah, look at how hot that is. And then Yellowstone Lake. There's its earthquake signature. It actually looks like two earthquakes here at West Thumb. Very small. Yesterday, the earthquake at 20:02 West Thumb. There's its signature at Yellowstone Lake. Yeah, it came in at that area, you can tell, because there's virtually no P wave on it. So at the top here is Yellowstone Lake. This one here is West Thumb. And I'm going to pull this over. And we're going to extract this. You can see there's another earthquake before that. I think that's the one I already did. We'll make that bigger. There you go. And we're going to pull this here. Looks like a series of earthquakes. Let's take a look. And we'll make that bigger. Oh, there's the phone. Sorry about that. Anyways, there's the earthquakes. And let's make that larger. Little tiny microquakes. And we'll do the horizontal. Now, this could very well be tectonic. See how it's rounded here? And that one, too. This is not. And this one, it is and it isn't. It's probably two right there. So let's pull it from Maple Creek and see what we got. All right, we'll make that larger. Change the horizontal. See what we got. Yeah, I've noticed on different monitors that I have been able to get to work here at Maple Creek. Yeah, you can see that there's magma on the move. West Thumb, some small little microquakes going on. We'll make that larger. Yeah, it's got a very small P wave on it. And it doesn't really show up at Yellowstone Lake. And then we got another one. Looks like two. Let's see. No, just one. Okay. Then we'll go back another 4 hours. Here's that 3.6 right there. And then lots of other little stuff that's been going on at Yellowstone Lake and West Thumb. And there's the current static camera picture of Old Faithful. Remember, I talked about how this dome back here, that's the Mallard Lake Resurgent Dome. That is the dome as the magma comes up, pushing up the ground. It's currently 34 degrees there. Cloudy, not snowing. Yeah, look at all that snow. Oh, there it just changed. All that snow that's gone. So, if you have any thoughts or comments or questions, please put it down below. Have a wonderful day. Please stay safe, and I will talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.